In today's video, I will show you how to calibrate the bed of R3D printer. As a printer to show the whole process, I chose Ender 3. In fact, the whole process is very simple. First, we have to find a position of calibration screws on the print bed or calibration wheels right under the print bed. First of all, we need to find out how straight bed we have and possibly which corner is the highest so that we can level to it with other corners. Before we start, we need to check the nozzle. The nozzle should be totally clean. If our nozzle is not clean, we will heat it up and clean it. If we have a filament loaded into a hot end, we will remove it. This avoids leakage of the filament during calibration. Now, clean the nozzle slightly and wait until the filament stops flowing out. Once the filament stops flowing out, remove it with tweezers. Now, move the print bed as slow as possible. We do this by rotating all the calibration wheels counterclockwise. All but one. We will leave this completely free. Now, preheat the printer for the material we will print from and wait a moment for the nozzle and the bed to warm up properly. This will put the printer in the same state it will be in during printing. This we have to do because of the thermal expansion of the materials. The bed, but also the nozzle, thanks to the warming up, they can easily change their size, the bed can bend down, and our calibration could be inaccurate. When the nozzle and the print bed are warmed up, we will home all the axes. It means we will let all the axes move to their end stops and reset their positions. Now we unlock all axes. Only lock the Z axis by moving it 1 mm up and back down. When the X and Y axis are unlocked, let's see which corner is closer to the nozzle. As we move, we watch the nozzle approach and move away from the bed. Here we can notice that the nozzle is relatively close to the bed. This could be our top corner. And now the nozzle is moving away from the print bed. This implies that our main corner is the right rear corner. That's why we will move the nozzle over it again. The nozzle should be exactly where the calibration screw is located. Rotate the calibration wheel to bring the print bed closer to the nozzle. Not entirely, just to 0.5 mm. And we move to the second highest corner where we repeat the action. Now we move to the last corner and repeat the action again. On the way, we see that the nozzle does not touch the print bed, which should not happen since this corner was lower than the previous two. When we are done, we try to repeat the path to the original highest corner with the nozzle. There should always be some space under the nozzle. If everything is fine, we will move the nozzle to the last any used corner. Since we have space also here, we can go to calibration itself. So we take a thin sheet of paper into your hand, just standard office paper or similar, and move to our my corner. Turning the calibration wheel smoothly will bring the print bed closer to the nozzle. Place paper between the nozzle and bed. Move the paper while turning the calibration wheel. Rotate the wheel until the paper begins to rub against the nozzle. At the moment, we stop and move to the next corner. When moving between the corners, the nozzle should never be rubbed against the print bed. Here we try again. We will do the same on the third corner. Now we move to the last corner. If the nozzle will rub on the bed, turn the calibration wheel in this corner and move the bed away from the nozzle. When the gap between the nozzle and the bed is sufficient, insert the paper under the nozzle and perform the calibration here. We repeat the process several times until we have the same distance between the nozzle and the print bed at all corners. If the calibration seems to be complete, we can proceed to the test print. Insert the filament back into the extruder and push a little bit of the filament through the nozzle. Let's prepare the print bed. In my case, I will just clean the bed with isopropyl alcohol. Now we will download a model to test how well we have done the calibration. We set the model a bit smaller than the actual size of our print bed. We adjust the height of the model according to the height of the first layer. Set two lines around the test model. And export the model for our printer. Insert the card into the printer and start printing our test model. At the beginning of the print, it will make two lines around the model. Swiping your fingers over the line can verify that our nozzle is not too far from the print bed. After printing, we will have a closer look at the printed model. If we see gaps between the lines, it means we need to bring the print bed closer to the nozzle. If we see that the filament accumulates in the corners of individual objects, it means that the nozzle is too close. As you can see, most defects were on the left side. Therefore, place the print bed back in its original position. Attach it and focus on the left side. Gently rotate the calibration wheels to bring the print bed closer to the nozzle. Then clean the print bed and try to print the test file again. When we look now, we can notice that the original beauty flaws have been corrected. As we can see on the right side, but mainly in the middle, the print bed is now a little bit closer than it should be. How to fix this? How to have a perfectly calibrated print bed and always the perfect first layer? That's exactly what we will look at in the next video. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. If yes, consider clicking the like button or subscribe to the channel. If you want to support the creation of other videos, you can do so by clicking on the link below the video. Thank you for watching. I will look forward to seeing you next time, and remember that even impossible is possible.